Today Network, and you are watching Headlines Today. Refreshingly different.
Under intense international pressure, Pakistan finally appears to be cracking down on non-state actors. After detaining Lashkar's 2611 terror mastermind Zakir Rahman Lakhvi, Pakistan has put Jaish-e-Mohammed chief Masood Azhar under house arrest. But the question is, what will this achieve? Jail Musharraf had put Masood Azhar in jail for a year after the attack on Indian Parliament. Now, Azhar came out when international pressure eased, and then it's been business as usual. Can we trust Pakistan to crack down on terror seriously this time? That's the question we're asking.
Swoop down on terror camps. Zakir Rahman Lakhvi arrested. Maulana Masood Azhar under house arrest. India's most wanted man, Maulana Masood Azhar, has been confined to his multi-storied house in the model town area of Bhawalpur. Masood Azhar's house was ringed by security personnel and restrictions imposed on his movements. This is not the first time that the Jaish-e-Mohammed chief's movements have been restricted by Pakistani authorities. Every time the Indian government demands his extradition, he's confined to his under-construction headquarters in Bhawalpur. The Jaish-e-Mohammed chief was released by the Indian government along with two other terrorists in 1999 in exchange for passengers of the IC-814, Indian Airlines flight hijacked from Kathmandu to Kandahar. Immediately after his release, Azhar quit the Harkatul Mujahideen to launch the Jaish-e-Mohammed. Azhar is also accused of masterminding the December 2001 attack on the Indian Parliament. After Jaish-e-Mohammed was declared as an international terrorist organization, Azhar was formally arrested by Pakistani authorities only once on 29th of December 2001. However, a three-member bench of the Lahore High Court ordered his release in 2002. Late on Sunday evening, Pakistani security forces arrested 20 members of the Jamaat-ul-Dawah, a charity front organization of the Lashkar. One of the arrested men, Chief Commander Zakir Rahman Lakhvi. However, Pakistan does not agree that these men could be behind the Mumbai terror attacks. Pakistani Army spokesperson Major General Athar Abbas said, and I quote, "It's quite premature to establish links of the arrested persons with the Mumbai terrorist attacks. It seems Pakistan has swung into action only and only due to international pressure." He goes on to say, "The operation is going on in Muzaffarabad and some other parts of the country. Some arrests have been made, including a top man of the Lashkar. We do not want to go into the details of the operation because of certain reasons and sensitivity of the matter. The arrests and detentions are small steps in the right direction, but will Pakistan follow it up with concrete action or will it remain a sham like before?" Your report, Headlines Today.
So a real crackdown or a sham? We have with us former Foreign Secretary Lalit Man Singh. We also have with us a keen Pakistan watcher and senior journalist, Saeed Naqvi. Welcome both of you. We will talk to you about how serious is Pakistan, or is it just paying lip service? Pakistan has ruled out giving India access to Lashkar-e-Taiba commander Zakir Rahman Lakhvi. Pakistan's defense minister Chaudhry Ahmad Mukhtar said only Pakistani authorities can question Lakhvi to ascertain whether he has any terror links. India will not also be given access to Masood Azhar. So does that answer your question about how serious is Pakistan?
Images of India's most wanted. Men who have fought terror and mayhem. We have been screaming out of our lungs asking Pakistan to deport them, but to no avail. But even as reports of Masood Azhar's detention surface, India remains skeptical. That's because every time the Indian government demands his extradition, he's confined to his home in Bahawalpur in Pakistan.
I think we'll have to wait and see a little bit. We cannot forget Pakistan's track record in this. They have in the past, when the heat gets excessive, they've picked up one or two people, taken the pressure off.
After the September 11th attacks, Azhar was detained for a year. Later, after the parliament attacks in 2001, he was formally arrested by Pakistan. However, a three-member review board of the Lahore High Court ordered his release on December 14, 2002. But experts agree that the detention could well be a cosmetic effort to show the Western world of Pakistan's affirmative action.
The LET was banned. There were arrests of other terrorist elements in Pakistan from time to time. But the results we have seen is that this is only cosmetic. And there is a reason for that. The reason is that there is a symbiotic relationship.
A sensible strategy to keep on applying the pressure on the civilian government and on the army. I think the whole idea, this whole idea of the list that has been sent to the UN, is basically the idea is to apply pressure on the army.
While India may question the genuinity of Pakistan in cracking down on terror operatives in their country, the fact remains that India too was unable to file a charge sheet against the very same Masood who was in an Indian jail for 5 years. In New Delhi, Geeta Mohan for Headlines Today.
So Hafiz Mohammed Saeed was detained, he was let off. Maulana Masood Azhar was detained, he was let off. How serious is